हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू टुडे सेशन ऑफ सीएस एकेडमी। लैक्स ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स आर अपीयरिंग कॉम्पिटिटिव एग्जाम्स एवरी ईयर, बट दोज हु फॉलोड बेस्ट स्ट्रेटजी एंड प्लानिंग ओनली सक्सेडेड इन द फर्स्ट अटेम्प्ट ओनली। हियर इन दिस वीडियो आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू द बेस्ट स्ट्रेटजी फॉर एवर। बिफोर गोइंग इन टू योर प्रिपरेशन, you should know that what is the need of examination rather than the syllabus of examination. Most of the students first will see the syllabus and they're scared, and they don't think that what is the importance of syllabus and what is the importance of exam. Here it will let you know that how to avoid fear with a lot of syllabus. Everyone is putting their efforts and hard work during their preparation, but our main aim is we should turn our aim into the success. To see our success in our future, what should we do is we should do smart work rather than the hard work. That is, for example, a subject carries 20 marks and other subject carries 2 marks. If you spend more time on the subject carrying 2 marks rather than the 20 mark subject, it means it's a meaningless. Here, smart in the sense that we should select the most priority subject and that subject carrying marks, and we should prefer during our preparation the most carrying mark subject first. Here some smart study tips I will tell you. The first point is the importance of previous papers. Every student thinks that how much syllabus I completed, that's it. We can't think that how many marks that completed syllabus carries. Here what you have to do is just refer previous papers and make your own analysis between the syllabus and marks. Here I can say damn surely that most of 70 to 75% of marks will be covered in only 50% of your syllabus only. So first focus that 50% syllabus rather than scrap which carries very less marks. And some students tells that how should I prepare GATE, IES, ISRO, SSC, RRB JEE at the same time. Here you should know that in most of engineering exams almost 90% of syllabus is same, but the difference is just type of questions asking in the exam, like numerical based exams like GATE and concept oriented exams like ISRO, SSC. Here rather than focusing on theory part, you should focus on the application of the theory part. And the second point is how to complete syllabus quickly. First of all, try to complete the syllabus which is coming very frequently or repeatedly in exams, subject wise and pakka concepts. After finishing that, what will happen? You will be in touch with each and every subject concepts, and the rest of syllabus you can complete thoroughly. This will ensure that your selection in your exam. And the third point is how to manage time during the exam. Before going into the exam, you should analyze yourself that how many questions are asking in exam, what is the total time. For example, exam carries 100 marks and 3 hours of time, that is each 1 mark carries 1.8 minutes, that in the sense that 108 seconds. That is, for each 1 mark you should not use more than 108 seconds. If you use more than that, means you are in the back part. And one more important point here is you should remember each and every question carries negative marks also. So think over it. If you analyze like this before going into the exam, you will complete exam within the time whatever they give without any stress and tension. And the fourth point is exam tension. That is, just 3 hours of exam will decide our entire 1 year preparation. So feel like stress free. If you feel stress, just make a meditation, just 1 or 2 minutes. It will make you faster and quicker. And the fifth point is the type of questions asking in exam. There are only 2 types of questions only: easy for all and tough for all. If you are solving a tough question, you are thinking that you are not getting answer. That means you will feel like somewhat stress. Here, what you have to realize is, if you are a pakka prepared candidate and you are not able to solve, means that question is tough for all, then why to worry? So no one can solve 100% of questions in the exam. So don't panic and don't worry about the tough questions. If you are a pakka prepared candidate, you will definitely solve that question. Or else, if you want to solve the next question, just leave the question, and at the end of the exam you will have some time and spend some time for the tough questions. And the sixth point is sharp nose. This is most important one. Many students are asking me that how to prepare sharp notes, which point I should note in the sharp notes, and what are the preparation strategy to prepare the sharp notes. Here I will tell you. Here the first point is, note the very important formulas first, with subject wise and chapter wise, and note the frequently asked concepts in the exam, and some concepts which you should remind before going into the exam. That's it. You should not note total subject into your short notes. That is not a short notes. And the short note should understand yourself and make it your own. Why I am telling the short notes is very important means, before going into the exam, that is 1 day or 2 days before, you can't revise all your subjects, all your syllabus within 1 day or 2 days. At that time, the short notes what you prepared, it will make you to learn within the very short period, and you will revise all the subjects within 10 or 20 papers only. And the seventh point is test series. It will play key role in your success. Many of students asking me that, is test series mandatory? Yes, mandatory. What is the need of test series? I will tell you. It will make you more perfect in each concept, and you can rectify if any mistakes and any doubts you have, and it will make you to feel like real time environment, and you will avoid the tension. And the selection of test series depends on you only. For example, if you take GATE exam, there are plenty of academies providing test series like Grade Up, Ace Academy, Medizin, Exergic, like that. And the next point is coaching. Many students are asking me that, is coaching mandatory? I say that if you have good subject knowledge, then there is no need of any coaching. You can prepare yourself at your home only. But what you should do is, you must follow best strategy and planning, as like I am showing here. And if you don't have any subject but you are not able to take any coaching, then you can use some YouTube channels and follow like NPTEL videos of IIT lectures. This here NPTEL, in the sense that National Program on Technical Education Learning, these are best videos forever for technical subjects, and make a notes for each subject during watching of NPTEL videos. Here I am providing link of NPTEL in description. You can download and watch it. The next most important point is, before going to the exam, check all your requirements like pen, pencil, ID proofs, money for a ticket. This is important because these silly things only will create a tension during the exam time. And some exams ask photo ID proofs and passport size photos also, like bar, sometimes gate also. Everything you should keep in your pocket one day before to the exam, and visit the center one day before. And the most important thing is, take care of your health. During exams, most of friends will feel like sick. So take some fruits and enjoy the preparation. Competitive exams preparation is like listening the same cassette repeatedly. That is, we should revise every day the total syllabus. Finally, I want to suggest you that don't follow others' preparation timings. Make your own timings. Do your work. Be like stress-free. Watch some motivation videos if you are in disturbance. And finally, your goal should be ultimate one. Do your level best for it. All the best for your exams. Thank you. Thank you for watching my video.